The most problematic area is having the laws based on Sharia law. In Iran, women don't have the right to choose who they want to be. They're not treated as free individual human beings. After revolution, women have been deprived of many rights, and one of them, one of the most obvious one, is the compulsory hijab. The Islamic regime used hijab as a tool to repress women, enabling their special forces and followers to abuse, violate, and subjugate women. As you know, Iranian women are as educated as men, but because of forced hijab and the better form of hijab, chador, they haven't been able to have important roles in society. Terrifying experience is realizing the fact that they are capable of doing anything to you, not only to you, but to your family too. There's no hesitation during interrogation, no justice in the courtrooms, and no law inside prisons. Behind those doors, there is no one who can help you. The only thing you have during your detention in prison is your life. And because of that, many activists and prisoners of conscience decide to go on hunger strike. I totally agree. In these countries, women have been oppressed, not only by their Muslim community, but also by their government. There are not many laws to support women's rights. Around the world, women are still fighting for gender equality, but in these countries, we are far from gender equality. And now, more than ever, women understand change will not happen unless they change their government and legislate new laws. ITC Women Organization goal is to achieve gender equality in Iran. We focus on women empowerment. We work with human rights, women rights, children rights, LGBTQ rights activists to raise awareness and to fight for their rights. None of these goals can be achieved in Islamic regime. So we need to fight for a future without Islamic regime and to fight for a democratic secular system to be established in Iran. Since gender equality is incompatible with Iran's Sharia-based law, the main focus is to fight all types of gender discriminations, to plan for a future based on democracy, secularism, and having laws based on Universal Declaration of Human Rights instead of Sharia-based laws. To encourage Iranian women to be present and visible and included during the transition period from Islamic regime to a democratic system. To encourage women to be involved in politics. And our goal is to have 55% of the seats in Iranian parliament. To join CEDAW and sustainable gender equality goals.